Hi to all the Form 4 students. This lesson, we will learn evaluating financial status. Okay? Last week, I think we discussed, last lesson, we discussed the first process, which is setting goals. So we have also discussed one example about Yusuf. So for this lesson, we will discuss evaluating financial status. Okay, so first of all, you must know assets and liabilities are the benchmarks for evaluating our financial status. Examples of assets are cash, okay, savings, real estate investments, fixed deposits, unit trust, or company shares. All these are assets. So you have to identify what is assets. Cash, savings, estate investments, fixed deposits, unit trust, company shares. And how about liabilities? Liabilities are bank loans, credit and debt, credit card debts, and other financial obligation. Okay, besides, we should know outstanding payments such as unsettled rent, okay, utility bills, credit card, and also phone bills, okay, electrical bills. So we need to evaluating our financial status, okay, because it helps us measure our performance, okay, in our long-term and short-term goals. Okay, so in order to achieve our long-term or short-term goals, we have to always evaluating our financial status. So as a general guide, we need to save money. Okay. How much we need to save money? Because we need money for basic needs. Huh? I think we need at least for 6 months for our basic needs like food, clothing, okay, expenses for our daily life. Okay, so for the next process is creating financial plan. So we need to manage our life, actually, life management. Life management based on financial planning help us monitor our cash flow. Okay, so we have to creating our financial plan. So there are two important components. Okay, there are two important components in constructing a financial plan. Okay, namely the sources of income and expenses. So these two are very important. Source of income and expenses. So income consists of two types. One is active income and the other one is passive income. Right. Active income is the main income, such as salaries, allowance, commissions, and other financial resources. All these are active income. Okay, so we need to highlight the active income like salaries, allowance, commissions that you earn, and also financial resources. All these are active income. How about passive income? Passive income consists of rent received, rent the room, rent the house, or interest received, or dividends and other investments. So both of these incomes are cash flows. So it's very important that incomes are cash flows. All right. So expenses consists of two types also. One is called fixed expenses and the other one is variable expenses. Okay, fixed expenses are expenses that must be paid or spent, such as rent, insurance, payments, housing loan installments, car installments, and also credit card payments. All these are fixed expenses. And how about variable expenses? Variable expenses will change. Variable means change every month according to our spending behavior. Okay, example like petrol expenses, grocery, electricity bill payments, water bill payments, or transportation fee. Okay, both of these expenses must be cash flows. So we want to talk about positive flow, cash flow, and negative cash flow. So we have two types. A positive cash flow, it means that the total income exceeds the total expenses, meaning that you are earning money more than what you spend. Okay, total income exceeds the expenses. If negative cash flow, meaning that total income less than total expenses. Okay, total income less than total expenses for the negative cash flow. So we always want to maintain positive cash flow. Okay, this is the third lesson for consumer mathematics. So for the past two lessons, we have discussed setting goals, evaluating the financial status. So today we'll discuss the steps that you need to consider before creating a financial plan. Okay, so we start with step one. So in order to create the financial plan, we need to define the short-term and long-term goals. So we have short-term and long-term goals. So we have to define what is our short-term and long-term goals. So make sure the definition is clear for short-term and long-term goals. For the second step, we need to make an initial budget to achieve each goal. For short-term goal, we have to have budget. Long-term goal, we have to have budget. And the short-term goal, the amount is less. Okay, long-term goal, you need to spend more because it need more timing, duration is longer, so the amount of money will be bigger. So this is the step two. For step three, we need to calculate monthly savings needed. Okay, have to do calculation in order to achieve the short-term and long-term goals. So we have to plus, minus, and then do some calculation based on our monthly savings so that we can achieve our short-term and long-term goal. These are the three steps first. So step one, define short-term and long-term goals. Step two, make an initial budget to achieve the goal. And step three, we need to calculate monthly saving needed to achieve the short-term and long-term goals. So we have altogether we have six steps. So these are the first three steps. So we will continue with the step four and step five and step six after this. But make sure you remember all the steps. Okay, so remember, you have to always recall the steps, repeat the step. Okay, memorize the step so that you won't forget. Okay, now we will proceed to the step 4 and step 5 and step 6. Okay, for step 4 is analyze spending behavior. Alright, Step five is set a time frame to achieve each goals. Okay, and step six is determine income strategies that will help to achieve the financial goals. So all the six steps, you need to memorize it. Okay, so this is important steps in order to design or create our financial plan. Okay, so please use a piece of paper, jot down all the six steps and try to memorize it. Okay, okay, let's see the example of an individual's financial goal. Okay, let's say this is your financial goal. You plan to get married, okay, at the age of 25 years old. So you need to allocate, you need to have money, 15,000. So you have to start saving after your working. Okay, so at the age of 25 years old, you need 15,000. After 5 years, maybe you want to buy a car, you want to own a car. So you need to have 80,000, okay? So you need to plan to save for another 80,000 after you married for during the 5 years. Then when you reach 35 years old, maybe you want to buy a house, okay? So the house need more money. So let's say the house, you need to spend about 150,000, all right? So you need to plan how to save your money. And when you reach 55, maybe you need to have a break. You want to go for travel. You want to go to the around the earth for traveling. So you need money. So let's say you allocate, you save about 50,000. When you reach years 55, you want to go visit country that you like to go. Okay. So when you reach age of 60, you should have money for you to retire. Let's say you need about 1 million, okay, because you're not sure how long you will live. Okay, so all these are very important. You have to plan. Financial management helps us to develop, okay, strategies, okay, to manage our spending behavior, okay, so that we can have a better life. Okay, this is how important is financial management plan. So you can also prepare a table, okay, with the goals like get married, own a car, and also the starting year. Let's say 2019 is the starting year and your target year is 2022, within 3 years. So duration is 3 years. And your total money that you need is 15,000, and then your monthly saving, how much you need can save in order to achieve your short-term target or long-term target. So you just